Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about vectors.
Not that type.
We're going to talk about the arrowy things that you see in maths and physics. And in particular, I'm going to explain to you what it means to sum them up. I'm going to show you how to do that mathematically so that your teacher is happy and you pass your exams. And then at the very end, I'm going to show you a really cool trick so that you can add vectors faster than you ever thought possible. Let's get to it. So what is a vector? A vector is a quantity that has both direction and magnitude. We typically use arrows to represent vectors because arrows have also direction and magnitude. The concept of quantities with direction is an intuitive one. Moving this car a certain distance this way is not the same as moving it the same distance, but this other way. They end up in different places. A number alone cannot fully express this movement, but a vector with direction and magnitude can. The question is, how do we sum up vectors? Because vector addition can seem very tricky with all the directions and magnitudes getting mixed up, but the principle is exactly the same. Let me show you in the whiteboard. When we sum two vectors, we put one after the other one, and the resulting combination is another vector that is the sum of those two vectors. When the two vectors are pointing in the same direction, the result also points in the same direction, and its magnitude is just the sum of the magnitudes of the vectors involved, as if they were just numbers. However, if the vectors point in opposite directions, now, the result also lies on the same line, but its magnitude will now be the difference between magnitudes. And that's because each vector counteracts the other, and the result is a normal difference as if they were just numbers. But if the vectors don't fall in a line, the result of summing these two vectors together will be another vector with a completely different direction and magnitude to any of the ones involved. One important detail about vector addition is that it's both commutative and also associative. This might sound like big words, but it's exactly the same that we do with numbers. Commutative means that we can reorder the vectors in the sum however we would like, and we will end up with the same answer. And associative means that we can regroup the vectors and also get the same answer no matter what. So now we understand what adding vectors means, and it's time to do that mathematically. Ironically, we need numbers for this. You might know that we commonly represent vectors as the length of their axis. That's their x component and their y component. Well, when we add vectors, like the red and the black one, we can use this representation to help us get a result. So we take the red vector, which is -2, -4, and we add it to the black vector, which is -2, -8. All we need to do is sum the x components together and the y components together. In this case, the result would be -4, -4. That means our new vector should be something like this, being -4 and 4. And sure enough, if we take the black vector and we make sure not to change the direction, the result is exactly the same. Notice how here I can do the same thing in the opposite direction. So if I take my black vector and I add my red vector, the result is again the same -4, -4 vector as we calculated here. So let's use all this knowledge now to solve a more realistic problem, one like you can get from your teacher. We have four vectors and we're asked to sum them up together. To understand better what we're going to be doing, I'm going to do it graphically so that you can follow along. First, I'm going to take the blue vector because it's the simplest one, it has a zero. I put it on the horizontal axis and it goes up to minus 6, just like we thought. Now I take the black one. And why do I take the black one? I take the black one because minus 6 and 6 is going to cancel each other out, so we're not dealing with big numbers. As you can see, we go 6 on the horizontal and minus 5 on the vertical. And we end up at this point. Now I take the green one because basically the same reason. Minus 5, 5, it should cancel each other out on the vertical line. So 5 up and 8 to the right. And we end up at this point. And now I have no choice. I have to take the little red vector, which goes 3 to the right and 3 up, as the component suggests. This is our resulting vector, a vector that would have by coordinates 11 and 3. But if you realize when I was doing all these things, what I was actually trying to do is cancel the coordinates so they are very small. And we can do the same just looking at the numbers and the components. Minus 6 and 6 goes to 0, so I am left only with an 8 and a 3, which gives me 11. Same thing goes with minus 5 and 5. They cancel each other out and I'm left with a 3. Whoa, I have the same result that I got graphically. This is the fastest way you can do it. Just sum up the components, don't worry about how the vectors look. Aside from using an online calculator, there's really no fastest way to do it. And that's it. Adding vectors is not complicated once you understand how to do it. And I hope the video helped you do that. If you have more questions about vectors or anything else, we have more than 2,000 calculators ready to help you. So check the link in the video description. If you're looking for another video to watch, I recommend this one over there. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video about vectors and subtraction. Bye!